Let us have no fear in approaching the throne of grace to receive mercy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My fellow Christians, those who are around here who understand English, we are a group from Uganda, Kampala, who are making our pilgrimage. We came to the canonization of Pope Paul VI. Now we are ending our pilgrimage here in Fatima, where Our Lady appeared here exactly in this place on the first time, 13th May 1917. Last year, there were many people here. Pope Francis came here to canonize Jacinta and Francesco. So this is a great honor for us as a group to be in this place, which is a place of peace. Our Lady was saying peace for everyone. So we are grateful, and our Mass, we shall be thanking the Lord who has brought us here and to ask him to bless us and all the people, especially in our continents, the 54 countries we have, and also in our country, Uganda, the land of martyrs, that we may feel every time protected by her who was chosen to be the mother of Jesus and to be our mother. Now as we come before her, she was always telling people penance, telling the children, her message is still valid today. Our Lady follows each and every one. And actually in the documents they say she never stops to be a mother. She's our mother. We are wicked people, smaller people, people of little faith, but at the same time she knows that we need her as a mother. So we present ourselves as we are and we ask her for the graces necessary that we may be humble as she was humble, that we may be dedicated as she was, that we may have hope that there is eternal life, that our life here has a meaning, that all of us, we are special people. Now, let us recognize our sins and so say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I've, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and what I've failed to do, through my faults, through my grief, therefore, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me. May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. O Lord, have mercy. O Lord, have mercy. Mercy, oh Lord, mercy, oh Lord, have mercy. Christ have mercy. Jesus Christ have mercy. Oh Lord have mercy. Oh Lord have mercy. Oh Lord have mercy. Let us pray. Father, you have given us the mother of your Son to be our mothers also. Grant us that by obeying the appeals of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may always walk through prayer and penance for the kingdom of Christ and attain eternal happiness. We ask you through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the name of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
The first reading. I saw the New Jerusalem as beautiful as a bride, all dressed for her husband. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 21, verses 1 to 5. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth had disappeared now, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city and the new Jerusalem coming down from God out of heaven, as beautiful as a bride, all dressed for her husband. Then I heard a loud voice call from the throne, "You see the city? Here God lives among men. He will make his home among them. They shall be his people, and he will be their God. His name is God with them. He will wipe away all tears from their eyes. There will be no more death, and no more mourning or sadness. The world of the past has gone." Then the one sitting on the throne spoke, "Now I am making the whole world, the whole of creation new." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. You are the highest honor of our race.
You are the highest honor of our race.
May you be blessed, my daughter, by God Most High, beyond all women on earth. And may the Lord God be blessed, the creator of heaven and earth. The response: you are the highest honor of our race. The trust you have shown shall not pass from the memories of men, but shall ever remind them of the power of God. The response: you are the highest honor of our race. God, grant you to be always held in honor and rewarded with blessings, since you did not consider your own life when our nation was brought to its knees. The response: you are the highest honor of our race. Let us stand to welcome the gospel.
Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. Alleluia,
alleluia,
alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, 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 amen. Blessed are you, Virgin Mary, who believe that the promises made you by the Lord would be fulfilled. Alleluia, 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 amen. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary of Magdala. Seeing his mother and the disciples he loved standing near her, Jesus said to his mother, "Woman, this is your son." Then to the disciples he said, "This is your mother." And from that moment, the disciple made a place for her in his home. Brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord. So, my brothers and sisters, we have come here for a pilgrimage. Those who don't know us, First of all, I'm Father Charles Ruanga Sewava from Uganda, Kampala, Archdiocese of Kampala, with my fellow pilgrims who are supposed to be 25. And this is a great honor for us to come to Fatima. Last year, I was watching on the TV the Pope canonizing Jacinta and Francesco, two younger saints in the church. 13th May 1917 changed the whole world when a lady appeared to these children and sent a very strong message that each one of us is in God's plan, that each one of us is very special. So all of you have come here for the pilgrimage. You should be giving thanks to the Lord that you are here today. The message of Fatima is very, very powerful. First of all, Our Lady of Peace. Nossa Senhora de Pace. So the one who comes to bring this peace. Another point is to make us know that she's our mother. All of us, we know the importance of a mother. A mother is one who has at heart her children. Whether they are good or not, she cares. She's not indifferent. Another point is also to show that there is the presence of God. You know, some people doubt, you know, they say whether God exists or not. This is a sign that the message we give from the gospel is not something fabricated by man, but it's a message of hope. So as we come here, we have come here to bring up whatever we have in our hearts. So we should be open. John Paul II, when he was beginning his pontificate, is now a saint. He said, open your hearts to God. Open the doors. And actually shouted in Italy, aprite le porta Cristo, aprite, open the doors. So we have come here to open the doors of our hearts. Perhaps we have not been very kind, or we have been very proud, or we have not been thinking about others. This is the time to open our hearts. And Our Lady is always waiting for us. And also to accept our, you know, just as we are, you know, just to accept. I work in a parish in the Kampala, and I see people struggling, trying to, you know, to see what is the meaning of life. And all those people have a hope. So we have come here as people of hope. We have not lost hope. So Our Lady told the children, please keep on praying. Don't give up. And the children are buried there. They died very young, Jacinta and Francesco. They were beatified here on the 13th May 2000, the year of a great jubilee by Pope, now Saint John Paul II. And he really believed that Our Lady of Fatima saved him when he was shot on the 13th May 1981 in St. Peter's Square. And the one who shot him, Ari Aka, who was 23, when he went to forgive him as a Christian, he told him, I don't know why you are alive. I wanted just to kill you, and I knew that I'd killed you, but your God must be powerful. So brothers and sisters, whatever you have in your hearts from Uganda, Kati bomba n'ebintu byonna bimulese mu mitima gyammwe. Mujja kukola ki? Kubereka wano. If you have anything which in your heart, you bring it the Blessed Virgin Mary. We are in the month of October, so we are also very privileged. Yesterday was the day of St. Luke, 18th October. For us Ugandans, we are also very proud, not only Ugandans, but also Africans, that on 18th October, the Ugandan martyrs from Uganda, Charles Ruanga, Matia Muluma and companions, were canonized on the 18th October 1964. And we are here now. And the journey which the Pope the Sixth made to Africa, he came to one country only representing Africa, Uganda, Kampala, 1969, 31st July to 2nd August. We are here. The first bishop, South of Sahara, who was given to the whole church, came from Uganda by Pope Pius XII. That was in 1939. Don't you see? The first nuncio apostolic, who came from Africa, came from Kampala, Augustine Kasuja, now is in Belgium.
So we are not saying that we are great people. We never say we are great, you know. But we are praising the Lord and thanking him for what he has done for us. So questa è una grande occasione per noi di ringraziare il Signore perché ci ha aiutato di venire qui, di presentarsi davanti a lui. Dunque, il messaggio della Madonna, il messaggio è molto semplice. Pace, pace, pace. You can say that in many different languages. Peace, peace, peace. That's what the Blessed Virgin Mary wants. La paix, la paix. So when you start your prayers, you ask that you may have peace in your hearts. So we shall pray for all of you who are here, offering our mass and asking the Lord. For me, I'm praying for one thing and thanking the Lord. Next year I will be 40 years a priest. Some people even have not lived enough to be 40. What are you talking about? They wanted to live long, they never lived, you know. The Lord gives us, and through the prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The Holy Father told us, if you don't have time to pray, just say, Mother of God, pray for us. Santa Madre di Dio, prega per noi. Here they say, Nossa Senhora. Then they say, pray for us. Rogavi por nós. So we are praying that the Blessed Virgin Mary may pray for you and pray for one another. So we ask that peace in the world, that many countries now are in the world. In Europe, we have been hearing from Africa, a lot of terrorism, a lot of hatred, people are divided. So Our Lady has a plan. She says, peace, if you trust in me. So brothers and sisters, we are taking this pilgrimage very seriously, that we have come here. So let us give the Lord thanks and let us love one another. You have heard that in this gospel, at the cross was the Blessed Virgin Mary, and Jesus was about to die, and he said to John, that is your mother. Questa qui è tua madre. And now the same words are coming, that here we see where the Blessed Virgin Mary appeared for the first time, 13th May 1917. And this is the message coming from here. This is your mother. So are we going to accept her? Don't worry about your problems, your sins. No, you just say, you see me as I am, you are my mother. Io sono un grande peccatore, però nel mio cuore io ti accetto completamente come mia madre, Nossa Signora. So she's going to help you. So courage, my friends, don't give up. Don't, even when things are very difficult, don't give up. You may not have hope that you may say, I'm finished. You are not finished, because if the Blessed Virgin Mary came here, it was because of you. If the two saints are here, already canonized, it is because of you. Lucia is not yet beatified or canonized, but she's also with us. So that's the message of hope. So my message is, don't worry, trust in the Blessed Virgin Mary. Non preoccupati a prendere la fiducia nella presenza della Madonna Santissima. The Lord be with you all. Let us get up and offer our prayers today. Let us now ask the Lord to help us, all of us who are here, that we may be blessed in a very special way through the Blessed Virgin Mary. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for all the pilgrims who have come all over the world. I was asking the people in Cyprus, they say millions and millions of people come here, that the Lord may be able to bless and to give them peace and love. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for peace in the whole world, especially where there is a need of peace. We pray for people who believe in one God, that they may live together as brothers and sisters. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray that we may not give up hope, that we may accept Mary as our mother, that she may also come to our help, and we should be grateful for whatever she does for us. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for those who have asked us as we made our pilgrimage to pray for them, those who are sick, those who are suffering, those who are troubled in mind and body, that the Lord may help them. For this we pray to the Lord. Finally, we pray for the dead, especially those of our families, those who have been forgotten, those who are in need of prayers, that in the mercy and love of the living God, they may pass through suffering to eternal life. For this we pray to the Lord. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence, for having sent us your Son. We thank you for our blessed Virgin Mary, our mother. We pray that she may still continue to protect us and to love us. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the interim of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Blessed are you, God of all creation, through your goodness of this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made to become our bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, God of all creation, through your goodness you have this one to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Lord, this is the sacrifice. Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, we offer you these gifts of reparation, of praise, so that in celebrating the feast of the Blessed Virgin Mary, you may absolve us from our sins and guide our wavering hearts. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all powerful and ever living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. As we celebrate the feast of the Blessed Virgin Mary and praise you for your gifts, she, receiving your word in her immaculate heart, merited to conceive him in her virginal womb. And in giving birth to the Creator of the world, she prepared the birth of the Church. She, in receiving at the foot of the cross the testament of divine charity, received all men as our children, born to eternal life through the death of Christ. She, when the apostles were awaiting the coming of the Holy Spirit, she promised, the promised one, united our supplications to the prayers of the disciples, and this became the model of suppliant church. She then finally elevated to the glory of heaven, surrounds with her maternal love the pilgrim church, and lovingly directs their steps to the heavenly dwelling place until the glorious coming of the Lord. And so with all the angels and saints, we proclaim your glory and join in the hymn of praise as we acclaim: Holy, holy, holy.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Lord, you are holy indeed, the fountain of holiness. Let your spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread and gave the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you.
You are holy, you are holy, you are holy, Son of God. You are holy.
When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. Gave the cup to the disciples and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me.
You are holy, you are holy,
you are holy, Son of God. You are holy, you are holy, Son of God.
The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death. In memory of his death and resurrection, offer you, Father, this life-giving bread and the saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. May all of us share in the body and blood of Christ, be brought together in the unity by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world, together with Francis, our Pope, and the Bishop of this diocese, and the clergy. Remember brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of the resurrection, and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As our Savior taught us, we dare to say, our Father, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us as we forgive. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we await in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always." Our Lady of Fatima is known as Our Lady of Peace. So if you come here, you shouldn't quarrel. You shouldn't fight. This is the place of peace. I don't say that now go back and fight the people you left there. So let us share the sign of peace as brothers and sisters. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
From the cross, Jesus said to his mother, "This is your son." Then to the disciple he said, "This is your mother." Let us pray. Lord, having received with joy these seven sacraments, grant us, we pray, you, that they may lead us to eternal life, where we may rejoice forever with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Before I give you the communion, these people you see here, they are from Uganda, from the Archdiocese of Kampala, and they have been making a pilgrimage, as I told you, from Rome, Assisi, Lourdes, now Fatima, and now they will go back to their country tomorrow, so we'll pray for them. And please, can you stay after, because we have some communication. Tomorrow we shall be saying Mass at the church there, Angel of Peace, at 7:30 in the morning. The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth in peace. The Mass is ended.